Hello, everybody. This is Elijah Keating from WisdomSeekers.net. This is my logo. Phoenix Rampant or the Phoenix Rising? I guess that was a little quick. Phoenix Rampant or the Phoenix Rising? And this is for October 11th already. Almost the halfway through. Wow. 2023. And what is the energy like? Well, we'll find out what the energy is like, but let me tell you what I've been experiencing. There's a lot of pushing right now. And when we had this much time to adjust to karmic reactions, we now have this much time. So it feels like our choices, karmic choices, have been taken away from us. Well, in reality, they're still there. They're still the same, except that our reaction time has to be, I would say, between 100% to 1,000% faster. And I know you can't go above 100% faster, but it is what it is. Our reaction time, between acting, choosing, and reacting, it's very little time. So when something happens to you that you don't like, your first reaction should be stop, back up, look at it from a third party perspective quickly, go into your heart, and get an answer. And if you're not used to going into your heart, practice it. It takes time to learn. I know I work with people and I tell them go into their heart and they look confused. They look like, what the heck? And then they get this, it just feels numb, they say, or something like that. And I say, okay, that's fine. Now pull it out, go back in. What do you get? And it might take time to get the right answer, but after a while you will go, oh, I heard I should do this, or no, don't do that, for your best benefit. And if you don't choose to listen to it, that's fine. That's your choice. You will find that when you listen to your heart, then take it to your head, not the other way around. I know we are trained to be logical, but the first point should start in the heart. If you go to your heart, then go to your mind, then you will get better results, I promise you. And you're going to be shocked sometimes at what your heart tells you to do, because it's exactly opposite of what the logic tells you to do. Why? Because we're moving energy. We're moving from the third dimensional energy through the fourth, hopefully through the fourth rather than stopping there, into the fifth. And I would suspect most of us are at the fourth dimensional energy, and we don't want to stop there, I promise you. So you may, because we're no longer in the third and we're moving into the fifth, what was the correct thing to do before no longer is. So allow yourself to move with your heart energy first. All right. Oh, 4 minutes. Hey, I haven't got much time. Let's go for it then. So this is for the 11th of October. And let's see what the first cards are. The first card is be self-responsible. When something happens to you, don't go, they did it to me. Go, what in me caused that to happen? When you do that, life actually becomes faster, smoother, easier, and the hiccups, the karma reaction, is not as strong. It really isn't. It's also a sign of maturity when you go, what in me caused that? And then what the next card is, very funny card, for I believe it's Five of Wands. The next it is show off your skills. Be proud of your skills. That's exactly what it means. It doesn't mean you have to brag, and having a fat head is not what I'm talking about. But recreate, reenact, till it becomes part of you rather than something you have to think about. And that would mean the Princess of Swords. Look at your inner child. We all have inner children that are damaged and hurt. It's just part of nature, the part of the third dimension that we're trying to let go and release. And many of it comes from other lifetimes. In fact, I would say the majority of our inner child woes and hurts have come from other lifetimes. Because when I work with people, I've never run into anybody that was created in this lifetime. Always another lifetime. Why? I think it's because this is a cumulative lifetime. We're moving, shifting, so we're clearing everything up. And then we have the Three of Swords, which means, yes, there is problems we have to deal with. But when we clear the problems up, when we look at the inner child, then we'll have a way of dealing with it, which is, again, comes back to Three of Wands, of being self-responsible. How do we do that? In this case, for the 11th, do the feminine form of intuition. Allow it to come to you. Ask and allow it to come. And the second thing you do, the Queen of Swords, open your heart up. It's not the time to close down. When you close down, you lock things inside of you. When you open it up, you open it up so things can leave. And it also makes it easier for you to deal with your stuff. When you lock it down, you shove it into subconscious. When you open it up, you look at it, you let it go. Then, Two of Pentacles, you be patient. Allow the universe to step in and help you. When, and I know this works because I use it all the time, when I have a problem, I will sincerely tell the universe, I choose to let this go. I choose not to work with it. I choose to allow it to be gone. Then I sit back and I do nothing, because the universe is going to do it. It's going to step in, work some magic behind the scenes within your subconscious. I don't know how it works exactly, but it does. And we have got to the place where we can let things go. We don't have to feel the pain, the angst, the hurt. We just have to acknowledge that we have it and let it go. This is a relatively new experience, maybe even 4 weeks, 5 weeks, that I have not had to pull people through the absolute agony of the energy. Sometimes I will take them back and say, can you feel that? Can you understand why? Can you forgive that person? And when you do, can you forgive yourself? All right? This is the Six of Cups. We're doing this for our future. And the future is grand. I promise you it is. And I'm going to leave it there because we're almost at 10 set minutes. But the Nine of Cups. I love getting the Nine of Cups. And I always leave it for the last. It's being on cloud nine. It's being happy. Choose to allow the hurt and angst to go, and allow yourself to be joyful and happy. I promise you it will make life so much more easy. Namaste, namaskar, love you, and you will be loved.